Ali vratimo se samo na par minuta, jer želim privesti kraju u drugo poglavlje u tom zapisu događaja o Nabukodonozorovom snu.
But let's just have a look at this dream in Daniel chapter 2.
Nećemo ući u analizu svih detalja.
We won't analyze all of the details.
Želimo samo da prepoznamo neke bitne stvari.
But there are some very important things here.
Ja ću samo prepričati na brzinu, jer svi vi poznajete ovu situaciju.
You know the situation, so I'll just run you through it.
Kad je napokon Daniel pred Nabukodonozorom.
When Daniel comes before Nebuchadnezzar.
On mu daje jasnu poruku.
He gives him a clear message.
Nabukodonozoru, koji je priželjkivao da čuje da je vjerojatno on sve od glave do pete i sav zlatan i da se sve odnosi na njega.
Nebuchadnezzar, who wanted, of course, to hear that he was this statue from head to toe.
Ali njemu Daniel kaže, svo dužno poštovanje.
But Daniel tells him respectfully.
Ti si samo ta glava.
You are only the head, the golden head.
Nakon tebe.
After you.
Dolazi drugo kraljestvo.
There is another kingdom.
Slabije po vrijednosti.
Which is less in value.
Mi znamo bilo je Medo-Perzijsko.
We know that was the Medo-Persian.
Kaže, ni tu nije kraj. Nakon vas dolazi treće.
But even that's not the end. There's a third kingdom.
Grčko.
The Greek.
Ali ni tome nije kraj.
But that's not the end.
I onda, kaže, dolaze noge one od metala, čelika.
And then the legs of iron.
I iako Biblija ne kaže točno da je to rimsko kraljevstvo.
Even though the Bible doesn't clearly say it's Rome.
Ja vjerujem da mnogi koji tumače taj san su pravu kad kažu da je to bilo rimsko kraljevstvo i sve što iz njega je slijedilo nakon toga.
But I believe all the theologians and who studied that are correct. From all accounts it was Rome.
Ali cijela stvar ne završava s time.
But it still doesn't end there.
Jer mogao se i Nabukodonozor osjećat ponosnim.
Because the king could have felt quite proud.
Dobro, ja sam zlatna glava.
Yes, I'm the golden head.
Ja sam početak.
I'm the start.
A gledaj, svi ovi nakon mene dolaze iz mene.
All of these after me, they come from me.
Mogao je razmišljati o tome da on ima nekakve zasluge u svemu tome.
He could have thought that he had some points.
Ali zaključak izvještaja Danielovog je bio taj, ali
but
pojavi se iznenada kamen.
What does Daniel say?
Bez pripomoći ljudske ruke.
That all of a sudden there is a great stone that's coming without a hand.
I udara u temelj toga lika.
Which hits the foundation of the statue.
I od vas ne ostaje više ni traga ni glasa.
And from any of you there's no trace.
Ni spomena.
Not a trace.
Sve što ste gradili jednim potezom Božjim nema više nikakvu vrijednost.
Everything that you have built has just disappeared immediately by just one stroke of God's hand.
Svi vaši gradovi.
All of your cities.
Sve ono što ste smatrali najvećim postignućima.
Everything that you have think you've achieved.
Svi vaši neboderi.
All of your skyscrapers.
Sve vaše vlasti i organizacije.
Your governments, your organizations.
Sve ono što ste smatrali da predstavlja nekakvom snagom.
Everything that you believed was some kind of power.
Da niko vas ne može ugroziti s ničim.
That no one can come against you.
Da će sve to trajati zauvijek.
That it will all just indefinitely go on.
I malo diverziju mi dozvolite. Malo diverzije da odem na stranu.
And I'll just divert for a while.
Svi.
Everyone.
Ne samo Nabukodonozor i Babilon, Medo-Perzija i Grčka. Nego i danas, malo poslušajte kojim se govorom govori kad govore moćne sile u svijetu.
But not only Babylon and Medo-Persia and Greece and Rome, listen to what powerful countries or leaders around the world are saying today.
Svi oni sanjaju o nekoj veličini ili povratku na neku veličinu, nešto što njima pripada. Kako smo bili nekad snažni, mi hoćemo imati nazad to.
They're all dreaming of some kind of power or to go back to some glory days, to bring back a strength and a might.
Poslušajte samo u Americi neke od kandidata za predsjednika, kojim oni jezikom govore.
Just listen to the candidates for the elections in America. What language are they using?
Oni žele učiniti Amerikom velikom i snažnom još jednom.
They want to bring back the power and the glory of what America used to be.
I nigdje u tome, bez obzira što se oni pozivaju da su kršćani.
And nevertheless that they say that they're Christians.
Ali nigdje u tome nema pozivanja na Božju pomoć.
They don't call for God's help.
Nego ja sam jedini koji znam kako povratiti silu i snagu ove velike zemlje.
No, they're saying we are the only ones. I'm the only one that can bring back the glory.
U čemu je tu razlika između jednog Nabukodonozora i onoga što gledamo da se događa oko nas?
So where is the difference between one, for example, Nebuchadnezzar and what is happening today in our world?
Pa čak i jedan mali Tuđman prije 20 godina.
Even a small Tuđman 20 years ago.
Nemojte me sad krivo shvatiti.
Don't get me wrong.
Je govorio o tisućljetnom kraljevstvu hrvatskom koje dolazi.
Was talking about a thousand year a kingdom in Croatia that
Give
was
me
coming.
A break. U okolini u kojoj ja radim u Hrvatskoj, blizu Istre.
Where I work in Croatia.
U Gorskom Kotaru.
In Gorski Kotar.
U zadnjih 100 godina 4 zemlje su vladale nad tim područjem.
In the last 100 years, 4 separate countries have ruled over this region.
Ako idemo malo još nazad, možda bi i 6 našli. Ako Napoleona uključimo
i slično. If we go further to Napoleon, it'd be 6 countries.
Ako Isus ne dođe za 100 godina, ja ne vjerujem da će se to dogoditi.
If Jesus doesn't come for 100 years, but I don't think that will happen.
Tko će meni potvrditi da se još neće 5 zemalja izmijeniti ko će biti vlasnici istog teritorija?
Who will guarantee to me that there won't be another 5 rulers of that region?
Postoji na YouTube nekoliko videa koji su i takako dobro napravljeni.
There are a number of videos on YouTube very well made.
I možda ste i vi neke od njih i vidjeli.
Maybe you've seen some of them.
Gdje su neki koji znaju dizajnirati s kompjuterom, animacije raditi.
People who know how to design animations.
Prikazali kako su se kraljevstva mijenjala i moć i na ovoj zemlji unazad 2000 ili možda 3 dokle postoji zapisana povijest.
Have shown all the way back through history how the kingdoms and rulers have changed on planet Earth.
I onda dolaze do zanimljivog zaključka.
And then they come to a conclusion.
Da se te mape stalno šetaju.
The maps, the borders are moving all the time.
Nijedna od tih nije ista danas kao što je prije 50 godina bila ili 100 godina ili prije 300 godina.
None of them is the same as it was 10 years ago or 50 or 100 years ago.
I kako može arogantno čovjek govoriti ako Krist ne dođe, stavimo to pod tim navodnicima, a ne vjerujem da će biti toliko dugo.
And how can an arrogant person say if God doesn't come and we
da
don't
sad
believe,
ono što imamo to će ostati za uvijek.
That what we have now, that's how it's always going to be.
Kad to nije u naravi grešnog ljudskog roda da može izdržati da nešto zadrži dugo.
Because it's not in the nature of a sinful human being to hold on to something for so long.
I upravo te poruke je dao Daniel, ne Daniel, nego Bog kroz Daniela Nabukodonozoru.
And this was in fact the message that God through Daniel gave to King.
On je želio reći Danielu.
He wanted to say to Daniel.
Odnosno Nabukodonozoru.
And to King Nebuchadnezzar.
Možeš boriti se koliko hoćeš.
You can fight as much as you want.
Možeš čak i uživati u blagostanju određeno vrijeme.
You can enjoy a peace and good times for a while.
Ali trebaš znati da na kraju krajeva povješću ja upravljam, a ne ti.
But you have to know that I am the one that rule over history.
Ja postavljam kraljeve i ja ih skidam.
I place kings and I remove them.
Moji naumi planovi će se stvarati do kraja.
My plans will be fulfilled to the very end.
I to do posljednjeg detalja, bez obzira koliko mi pokušavali ga ometati u tome.
They will be fulfilled to the very last detail, no matter how much humans try to change things.
Ja ne znam kako to funkcionira između naše slobodne volje i Božjeg suvereniteta.
I don't know how it functions between our free will and God's sovereignty.
Ja vjerujem da Bog nam daje slobodnu volju.
I believe God gives us free will.
Ali nekako u svemu tome,
but in all of that,
na kraju stvari se završavaju kako on hoće.
At the end, they all work out how he wants them to.
Nitko mu iz ruku neće uzeti povijest i odvesti ne znam u kojem drugom pravcu.
No one can take the history from his hands and take it into another direction.
I sad dok svijet živi da doslovno na rubu propasti.
And now while the world is right on the edge of disaster.
Kad samo malo je potrebno da dođe do svjetskog rata.
Where very little is needed for a world war.
Na kraju krajeva ipak će biti kako Bog hoće.
At the end it'll still all work out exactly how God has planned.
Kad su ljudi u panici hoće li atomske bombe uništiti svijet.
When the people are panicking whether the atomic bombs will destroy.
kad svakog tjedna najavljuju novi 2-3 kometa ili ne znam čega je svemira koji trebaju tresnuti u zemlju svakog trenutka.
When every week we hear about different comets that are supposed to come and strike the world.
Kad nam kažu da će se pojaviti ovi tsunami koji će biti ne znam ja 300 metara visoki pa će cijele kontinente zbrisati.
When they tell us about tsunamis of 300 meter waves which will destroy whole continents.
Na kraju treba znati da na kraju će ipak biti kako Bog hoće.
We have to know that at the end it will still be exactly how God wants it to
be. Da Boga nitko neće zafrknuti povod za nos.
That no one will lead God by the nose.
Ja osobno vjerujem da u Noevo vrijeme Bog je dozvolio do maksimalne granice da koje je mogao dozvoliti.
I personally believe that in Noah's time God let the people go to the very edge as far as they could go.
I kad je znao da ako im dozvoli još samo jedan dan da će se stvari okrenuti naopako.
And that when he knew that if he allowed them to go one more day that things would be irreversible.
Po njegovom kalendaru crta je bila povučena.
On his calendar he drew the line.
Sud je došao.
It was the judgment time.
Ja osobno vjerujem da tako i u naše vrijeme.
I believe it's the same in our time.
Bog je toliko milostiv i dobar.
God is so merciful and good.
Da do maksimalne granice tolerira.
That he tolerates to the very maximum.
Ali on neće dozvoliti bez obzira da li je to riječ o superpower, moći ili je to riječ o nekakvim znanstvenicima koji mogu uništiti svijet.
But he won't allow it, whether we're talking about superpowers or very intelligent scientists, da, to destroy the world.
Da prekorači onu granicu koja bi poništila cijeli plan spasenja koji Bog ima.
He will not allow them to overstep the mark which would affect his plan of salvation.
Nije u Bibliji, ali ja vjerujem i kad taj dan dođe, to će biti crta povučena kad Bog zna preko tog ne mogu više dozvoliti ljudskom rodu da oni odlučuju.
Although it's not in the Bible, I believe there is a time, a day when God will draw the line where he will say you will not go any further.
Da zaključimo s ovime.
Let's conclude with this.
Da kroz cijelu povijest.
That through whole history.
Ljudski rod je u pobuni protiv Boga.
The human race is in rebellion against God.
Na različite načine.
In many various ways.
I znate što mogu bi opet zastraniti i početi govoriti o ilustracijama iz našeg vremena.
And I could certainly mention illustrations of our day.
Možda sutra, ali
maybe tomorrow.
Ali povijest, vjerujete mi da cijela povijest je u pobuni protiv Boga.
But do you believe me that the whole of history is in rebellion against God?
I da različite sile danas.
And that many different powers today.
Rade što kreativnije mogu, edali bi, ja bih rekao slikovito, skinuli Boga s prijestolja.
They're using creative ways that they can find to, in a way, remove God from his throne.
Ali na kraju, onaj isti koji je pobjedio na križu i kroz uskrsnuće, nije to zabadava napravio.
But at the end of the day, the one that won the battle on the cross and who was resurrected didn't do that in vain.
Da taj isti koji je pobjedio tada,
that same God that won then,
možemo imati povjerenja da i do kraja ostaje pobjednik.
We can have complete faith that he will be the victor to the very end.
A u međuvremenu,
but in the meantime,
kada mi je teško,
when it's difficult,
kada nam se čini da je svijet poludio,
when we think that the world has gone mad,
sjetimo se samo onih riječi da naš rat nije s krvlju ni s tijelom.
Let's remember that our battle is not with the flesh and humanity,
nego protiv vlasti u duhovnim sferama,
but against powers and principalities,
i onima koji su pod njima u našim sferama.
And the one that are the people that are under them amongst us here on earth.
Ali da će biti pobjeđeni za sva vremena.
But that they will be defeated for all time.